2022 looks to be a much stronger year overall for game releases, so today, like every year, we're breaking it down in two parts. Here are 10 or so games releasing in the first half of 2022 that we're really looking forward to. Starting off with number 10, Tiny Tina's Wonderlands. We've talked about this one already quite a bit since it was just announced a few months ago. Essentially, what this is a big blowout of previous Borderlands DLC that played with this whole concept of Tiny Tina, the zany side character, doing her own kind of fantasy adventure tabletop game. So here, what you have is a new Borderlands game set in a completely different environment with a kind of medieval, weird, mystical fantasy vibe to it. The weapon types seem totally different, the enemies seem totally different, just the overall flow and loop of the game, and the map seems to be different and more fantasy RPG focused, and it already looks like it's gonna be fun. If you're a Borderlands fan, you're probably digging what you're seeing. If you're not a Borderlands fan, the humor might still rub you the wrong way, but props to them for doing something different here. As of right now, Tiny Tina's Wonderlands is releasing March 25th, 2022. Next, over at number 9, we have Gran Turismo 7. Yes, Polyphony Digital is working on another one. It's been quite some time, they very much take their time, but it looks like Gran Turismo 7 is continuing the trend of just really upping all the stakes. More cars, crazier graphics, more options, more details overall, more fine-tuning, and we love to see it. Honestly, we're always excited when a PlayStation console gets graced with one of these really awesome games. These are, if you haven't played them, more hardcore simulation focused, so don't expect a lot of personality and fun and doing crazy jumps. No, this is like hardcore realism, real car stuff. So while there is a world for arcade racers, we have a blast with stuff like Forza Horizon and all that. The Gran Turismo series takes things a bit more seriously, so if you're a hardcore car enthusiast, hopefully you'll be happy with this one. So far, it's looked pretty good. As much as some of the updates sound like small things, it could just make for a really good, fun, gorgeous car game. And you know what? That's all we're really looking for. That's releasing, as of right now, March 4th, 2022. Next, over at number 8, we have Pokemon Legends Arceus. I think that's how you pronounce it. I'm bad at pronunciation, but this is the big one, folks. If you've been looking for a Pokemon game where you can run around a big 3D open world and catch Pokemon and battle, here you go. I mean, granted, they've kind of dabbled with it before, but this is the blown out crazy one. There's been criticism already for its graphics. For me, I just look at that as kind of like the limitations of the Nintendo Switch. Still, to have a fully 3D Pokemon game on the Switch is pretty exciting. The possibilities are high, especially considering this serves as kind of like a prequel story. It's in an older era of the Sinnoh region, and it's actually called something different. It was called the Hisui region, so it's kind of got this weird kind of old-timey Pokemon feel to it. You're still a guy or a girl with a cool hat and a jacket, but there's like a slight ancient vibe to it, and it's really cool. We're gonna be seeing new Pokemon, new trainers, new ways to fight, and most importantly, new ways to explore. There's a lot more going on in this one. If you're a diehard Pokemon fan, I suggest diving deep, because some of the info we do have is pretty cool for how it shakes up the formula, other than just, it's 3D. But thankfully, we won't have to wait too long to really see how it is. As of right now, it's releasing January 28th, 2022. Next, over at number 7, we have Sons of the Forest. This is the long-awaited follow-up to The Forest, which was a survival game with some really hardcore horror elements to it and just some good stuff. Sons of the Forest, interestingly enough, is hotly anticipated by Forest fans, but we don't know too much about it. It does look to be like a kind of new spin on what the original set up. You're once again stranded, you're using items, you're building shelter, and you're defending yourself from really creepy forest creatures. I actually like that they haven't shown off this game too much. I prefer the kind of less is more style, especially for a game where you might already be like, yeah, I'll check that out regardless. Because they've been so dark for so long and so quiet, I'm hoping that they took the money from the original game and really went hard here and are gonna give us something absolutely amazing. You know, that's of course just me armchair speculating, but there's some cool potential. And we'll find out if that release date holds, because right now it's set for May 20th, 2022. Now, next, over at number 6, we have Sifu. This is my personal most anticipated pick, just because of how cool it looks. I love games like this, especially from developer Slow Clap. These are the people behind Absolver, which was a pretty intense game with a hand-to-hand fighting system and a lot of challenge. This seemingly takes that gameplay framework, that combat system, and applies it to a different real style of game. There seems to be this mechanic where every time you die, you come back older, but just what they have going on here with the fight scenes, the way you can grapple and counter and fight enemies and use objects in the environment or use the environment itself to win seems so, so satisfying. If you played Absolver, you know that combat system absolutely hits. Even if the rest of the game was just kind of like, eh, that combat system is top tier. So for them to use that again and hopefully expand on it makes me just absolutely bet on this game. Next, over at number 5, we have Forspoken, which is the Square Enix action-adventure RPG that obviously looks like a really gorgeous tech demo, but is starting to reveal itself as a full game. At the time of making this video, a bunch of new gameplay videos have dropped, and it seems interesting. It's still a bit too early to tell, but the concept of you just kind of being a regular girl thrust into this weird fantasy world and using these cool powers, it's kind of almost like Infamous, but like you're a mage casting magic, seems pretty cool. Not to mention the fact that like just the visual style, the dialogue, the music, the art direction, all of that seems to be top tier, big budget AAA stuff. We're just hoping that the actual meat of the game, the gameplay, the exploration, and that story can really live up to what on the surface looks pretty cool. Forspoken is releasing on PC and PS5 as of right now. The news reports that it is a 2-year PlayStation exclusive, and we'll be playing that May 24th, 2022. Next, over at number 4, we have Stalker 2, Heart of Chernobyl. Now, the Stalker series is an absolutely legendary PC series. It's what a lot of PC gamers think of immediately when you think of the early 2000s games and just how it pioneered open world, kind of survival horror, resource management stuff in like a fun post-nuclear disaster world. And it seems like they're doing it again, but this time with a crazy budget and sick graphics. Recent videos with this thing running in Unreal Engine 5 look absolutely insane. We've seen little glimpses of gameplay with some combat versus human and mystical otherworldly things, including weapon attachments, using items. And if this is anything at all like the original Stalkers, it should make for a really tense experience. And now, thankfully, it has the graphics and really the mood and the atmosphere to really fill in the blanks and sell what made the original game so special. There's still time to play the originals if you never have, but we'll know for sure if this one is legit when we play it April 28th, 2022. Next, over at number 3, of course, you know we were going to mention it, Dying Light 2. After so many delays, it seems like they finally got it locked in. And, you know, the long story short, the reason why we're excited for Dying Light 2 is because we like the original game so much. Not only was it just a good old solid adventure open world game that kind of took the zombie formula and spun it on its head, but it was also supported with a ton of cool post-release content, and it was like the game gift that kept on giving. Now with Dying Light 2, it seems like it's taking that fun core gameplay framework with the parkour and the action and the violence and adding a lot more RPG and story elements to it. You making decisions on how to help out these micro civilizations that have cropped up after the viral outbreak. It looks like it's very much trying to do ambitious things with your decisions and who you help and what you do will actually change how these societies or these factions work. Not to mention the parkour moveset has also been upgraded and there's only melee weapons. There's no emphasis on guns because we're so far past the original outbreak that things are kind of broken down now. We're pretty pumped. We've talked this one to death, and thankfully, hopefully, we'll finally be playing it February 4th, 2022. Now down to number 2, we have Horizon Forbidden West. Now this just looks like an absolute blowout compared to Horizon Zero Dawn. It looks like they're taking everything but making it bigger, badder, and crazier. As you can see here, the combat and the action looks absolutely stunning. The amount of destruction, to the enemies, the enemy types themselves, the speed of it all seems really cool. Not to mention the beauty of the world. It's Aloy on a new adventure, new regions, new cultures, and apparently more of an emphasis on questing and towns and RPG stuff that we love. Apparently NPCs are gonna be much more interesting this time around. Me personally, I liked Horizon Zero Dawn quite a bit, but I didn't love it head over heels. This one seems like it's really gonna take it to the next level. Thankfully, we won't have to wait too long either. It's releasing February 18th, 2022. Now, finally, at number 1, of course, it's Elden Ring, What more can you say about this long-anticipated game from Software, the people behind Demon Souls, Dark Souls, Bloodborne, Sekiro? This is their next big thing, and it's very much taking the Soulsborne formula and framework and putting it in an open-world setting. And from what we've seen so far, it doesn't look like they're half-assing it. It doesn't just look like Dark Souls, but in an open world. Now, the way they've talked about how they're designing the bosses and how the flow works from the open world into dungeons seems to be pretty creative and also freeform, giving you a lot of choice. There's a jump button now, which is insane and really changes things up. The summons look cool. Everything about this game looks cool. If you're a fan of these games, if you're a fan of From Software, there's really, I can't like say anything. There's nothing that you don't already know, or there's nothing else to get you excited. You either know or you don't know. You're in or you're out. Fingers crossed there's no more delays on this one, and really every single other game in this list. But Elden Ring is releasing for all the major consoles on February 25th, 2022. But we also got some bonus games for you worth mentioning. Of course, Destiny 2 is getting the Witch Queen update expansion February 2022. Crossfire X, the first-person shooter, big in Asian territories, now with a campaign, is releasing on Xbox consoles February 10th, 2022. We're also getting The King of Fighters 15 on all major platforms February 17th, 2022. And the weird classic sci-fi game actually got a sequel. LX2 is releasing March 1st, 2022. But those are the 2022 games that we're really looking forward to for the first half of the year. Now, when we talk about the next half of the year, the fall season, things are gonna get probably even crazier. But for now, this first half is looking pretty good. So we wanna hear from you guys in the comments what you're digging the most. If you got your own top five most anticipated, be sure to drop it in the comments. We love seeing that stuff. But if this video helped you out, informed you, clicking the like button's all you gotta do. It really helps us out a lot, and we would very much appreciate that. But hey, as always, thanks for watching. We'll see you guys next time.